एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल डू वंडर्स। ओके, सो टुडे विल डू द टॉपिक लॉ ऑफ डिमांड। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स अगेन। व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ डिमांड? लॉ ऑफ डिमांड स्टेट्स दैट अदर थिंग्स बीइंग इक्वल, द डिमांड फॉर अ गुड एक्सटेंड्स विद अ डिक्रीज इन प्राइस एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स विद एन इंक्रीज इन प्राइस। Right? If there is decrease in the price, then automatically the demand for that commodity will increase. And if there is increase in price, then demand for that commodity will decline. Right? This is law of demand. Law of demand, हमें पता है क्या होती है? जब price decline होता है, decrease होता है, तो demand बढ़ जाती है. जब price increase होता है, तो demand डिक्लाइन हो जाती है, डिक्रीज हो जाती है। दिस इज लॉ ऑफ डिमांड, राइट? व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अदर थिंग्स बीइंग इक्वल? अदर थिंग बीइंग इक्वल मींस, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस थिंग? द टर्म अदर थिंग्स बीइंग इक्वल मींस दैट इनकम ऑफ द कंज्यूमर, हिज टेस्ट एंड प्रेफरेंसेस एंड प्राइजेस ऑफ अदर रिलेटेड गुड्स रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट। We have to assume this in law of demand. To know the law of demand, we have to assume. There are some assumptions. There are some assumptions which we have to assume, okay? So, there are four assumptions in this law of demand. The number one assumption is tastes and preferences of the consumers remain constant, okay? In law of demand, we know that law of demand holds goods when other things remain the same. It means factors influencing demand other than the price are assumed to be constant. Only our price is changing, but other things being constant, right? Jo taste or preferences hai consumers ki, we are assuming that they are constant, they are not changing. Only price is changing here in this law of demand. Okay? The number two is, there is no change in the income of the consumer. Consumer ki income mein koi bhi change nahi ho raha hai. It has to be constant. We are assuming that the income is constant in law of demand. Right? Then the number third is, prices of the commodity does not change in the near future. Now again, we are also assuming that in the near future, the prices of the commodity does not change. The prices will remain constant. We are assuming this thing, okay? In this law of demand, we have to assume that the prices in future will not change. They will remain constant. Wo bhi change nahi honge. Future prices bhi constant rahenge. Okay? Then number four is, the wealth of the consumers does not change. Jo consumers ki wealth hai, wo change nahi hoegi. वो कांस्टेंट रहेगी, ये भी हमें अज्यूम करना है। द वेल्थ ऑफ द कंज्यूमर इज कांस्टेंट। जो पैसा कंज्यूमर के पास आ रहा है किसी भी मीन से, इट हैज़ टू बी कांस्टेंट। कंज्यूमर के पास ना इनकम की कोई प्रॉब्लम है, ना वेल्थ की कोई प्रॉब्लम है। ओनली द प्राइजेस इन द मार्केट आर चेंजिंग, ओके? द प्राइजेस चेंजेस एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द चेंज इन प्राइजेस देयर इज चेंज इन डिमांड ऑफ द कमोडिटीज, right? So these are the four basic assumptions of law of demand. Taste and preferences remain constant. There is no change in the income of the consumer. Then prices of the commodities does not change in the future. And the wealth of the consumers also does not change. Now we'll do demand curve. Okay, what is demand curve? Demand curve is a curve that expresses the relationship between different quantities demanded at different possible prices of a commodity. Okay, this is demand curve. Demand curve kya hoti hai? Demand curve wo curve hota hai jo express karta hai different relationships jisme different quantities consumer demand kar raha hai different prices mein. Okay, so today we'll do demand curve. Okay, so now we'll do demand curve. This is the figure of demand curve. This is actually individual demand curve. What is individual demand curve? Individual demand curve is one that represents different consumer at different prices. हम इसमें assume कर रहे हैं कि ये demand curve है जो कि different consumers का different prices में वो कैसे demand कर रहा है market में. How is demanding the commodities in the market at different prices. We'll do that in this figure now. Okay, this in this figure, x-axis represents the quantities demanded by a consumer, and y-axis represents the prices of the commodity. Right? Now, individual demand curve has been represented in this figure, and in this diagram, demand of a commodity is shown in OX quantity, as I've told you, right? And prices on the OY axis. And demand curve, in short, demand curve is also known as DD. DD is demand curve. Short form of demand curve is DD. Okay? So every point on this demand curve expresses the relation between prices and quantities. Okay? Between the prices and the demand, which is demanded by the consumers. Okay? When at rupee 1, demand is for 4 units. See, at rupee 1, the consumer is demanding the quantity 4 units at rupee 1. Okay? When price is rupee 1, demand is for 4 units. Thus, demand curve slopes downward from left to right. At rupees 4, when the price of the commodity is rupees 4, the consumer is demanding the quantity 1. That means at rupees 4, there is only one quantity the consumer is buying in the market. At rupees 2, quantity demanded is 3. 3 units of quantity is demanded by the consumer. Then at price 2, 3, at price 3, only 2 quantities are being demanded by the consumers in the market. Okay, so our demand curve is moving downward from left to right. It means it is a negative demand curve. Demand curve slopes downwards from left to right means this is a negative demand curve. When the price is increasing, the quantities demanded is declining. When the prices are declining of the commodities decreasing, then the demand is increasing, right? So negative slope of the curve proves the law of demand, that is, at higher price demand is less and at lower price demand is more. Jab price zyada hoga to uski demand kam hogi, jab demand price kam hoga to uski demand badhegi market mein. Isko kehte hain demand curve always slopes downwards from left to right. डिमांड कर्व लेफ्ट से राइट में स्लोप करता है डाउनवर्ड, नीचे की तरफ. दिस इज डिमांड कर्व. ओके,